What is success? What is your definition of success? My definition of success is having a goal, constantly working towards that goal until it is reached, and then recommitting to a new one. Do you see yourself as successful? Successful as a mother, father, wife, or husband? Successful in your career? Successful in making meaningful change in the lives of others? What is it that you want to leave behind? What do you want your legacy to be? I agree. At first, it might seem like the most difficult question anyone can ask. But what I will share with you now is a tool to clear your thinking, a tool you can use in the comfort of your own home. There where you are sitting right now, forget about life as it is, filled with impossibilities and limited time. As of now, anything is possible. Close your eyes and take a deep breath in and out. As you are sitting, you suddenly realize the tremendous clarity that fills your thoughts. It fills your mind. Yesterday is clear. The day before yesterday, even clearer. Last week, last month, and last year is crystal clear. While astonished at the unexpected clarity you experience, you suddenly feel a sturdy wind blowing, getting stronger and stronger until you can literally feel your feet leaving the ground. Little by little, you are floating. And as you start going higher and higher, you try to grab onto anything you can find, the chair, curtain, the door. Then, all of a sudden, you are blinded by a bright light. With your eyes adjusting slowly but surely, you can't believe what you're seeing. All your loved ones, family, friends, in one place, together. Some are laughing and others are crying. And then, the realization sank in. You have passed away. Your family and friends were gathered for your funeral. A violin started playing your favorite song as your loved one walked towards the front of the room. The voices in the room silent. And while holding back the tears, he started speaking. He was speaking about you, telling your life story. He was reading your eulogy. The beautiful words flowing from his mouth caused tears to well up in your eyes. And just as they were about to overflow, you heard something. He said something you didn't want him to say. You tried stopping him, but no one could hear nor see you. You let your head down as you realized. It's too late. It's over. My time has run out. There is no going back. What has been said, and what's been done has been done. If you were given a second chance today, right now, what would you like your eulogy to say? Sooner than later, we all realize that time is not on our side. Knowing how you want your life story to unfold is a way to make sure that you use the time you have wisely. So, this is an invitation from me to you. An invitation to clear your mind. Go to a place where you feel safe and where you won't be disturbed. Take a blank piece of paper and pen and write your eulogy as spoken by the person you love most in this world. The person who you might be leaving behind in this world. What do you want to be remembered for? What would you want to have achieved? What type of mother, father, husband, or wife do you want to be remembered as? What legacy do you want to leave behind? Write it all down, word by word, black on white. And remember, anything is possible. O Lord, you've searched me and you know me. You know when I sit and when I rise. You perceive my thoughts from afar. You discern my going out, my lying down, and you are familiar with all of my ways. Before a word is on my tongue, you know it completely. You hear me in, behind, and before, and you have laid your hand upon me. Such knowledge is too wonderful for me, too lofty for me to attain. So, where can I go from your spirit? Where can I flee from your presence? If I go up to the heavens, you're there, and if I make my bed in the depths, you're there too. If I rise on the wings of the dawn or settle way on the far side of the sea, even there your hand will guide me. Your right hand will hold me fast. But if I say, surely the darkness will hide me and the light become night around me, even the darkness will not be dark to you. The night will shine like the day, for darkness is as light to you. For you created my inmost being when you knit me together in my mother's womb. I praise you, O God, for I am fearfully and wonderfully made. Your works are wonderful, and I know that full well. My frame was not hidden from you when I was made in the secret place. When I was woven together in the depths of the earth, your eyes saw my unformed body. All the days ordained for me were written in your book before one of them came to be. How precious are your thoughts about me, O God. How vast is the sum of them. If I were to count them, they would outnumber the grains of the sand. Search me, O God, and know my heart. Test me and know my anxious thoughts, and see if there is any offensive way in me. Lead me in the way everlasting.